Story Part 2. Andukals remained with the lion till it could walk again. He would hunt in the forest and share his food with the helpless beast. Every day he would clean and dress the lion's wound. Soon the lion was able to move about. Many times it followed Andukals whenever he went. In the meanwhile, Andukals' master had complained to the authorities that his slave Andukals had run away. Soldiers were sent in all directions to capture Andukals. They searched for him high and low but couldn't find him. At last, they came to the forest where Andukals lived. It so happened that Andukals had gone out alone that day while the lion rested near the cave. Both of them fell into the hands of the soldiers. The soldiers took them back to the city. They put Andukals in chain in a prison. The lion was caged. In those days, people who were found to be guilty of a serious crime were fed to wild beasts as punishment. Running away from one's master was a very serious crime at that time. Therefore, Andukals too was to be thrown to the wild beasts. On the appointed day, the emperor arrived at the circus and took his place. The crowd cheered loudly. The trumpeters blew the trumpet and Andukals was brought into the arena. His chains were unbound. He felt weak and dismayed. He was certain that this was the last day of his life. At the opposite end, a gate was raised and a ferocious lion was released into the arena. It had been kept hungry to make it more ferocious. Andukals was filled with fear, but he put up a brave front. The lion saw Andukals and rushed toward him, bounding and roaring. But suddenly it stopped in its tracks. Then it moved slowly forward. All its rage seemed to have melted. Andukals saw this too. Each friend recognized the other. To everyone's amazement, the lion bounded towards Andukals again. But when it reached him, it began to purr and rub its nose against him. Andukals hugged the lion. He wept with relief and joy. The audience, including the emperor, watched this tender sight in great wonder. People began to cheer Andukals and asked for his release. The emperor asked Andukals to explain the lion's strange behavior. When he heard the whole story, the emperor was also moved by the gratitude and friendship between man and beast. He ordered that Andukals should be set free. He would no longer be a slave. When the emperor asked Andukals what other reward he would like, Andukals replied that he did not want anything for himself, but he wanted the lion to be set free too. The two friends went back to the forest to live a free life. Here the story ends. How did you like it? Is it a good one?
Yes, very nice, ma'am.